So different raags evoke different feelings in different people. But when I hear this nipa of Megh, I can almost hear thunder. It's like a low rumble. That's my perception of Megh. Each person's perception is different. And now some people might even take, so Megh has a Malhar ang. And some people will also take a little bit of Kannada. But I don't take this. I take only five swaras. Sare ma pa ni. But I don't say sani sani. I just say ni because that's the way the ni is treated. So in Shuddha Malhar, re pa re ma sa re sa, but here re pa re pa re ma re sa. So in Megh, you would not stop. I mean, some people say Megh and Megh Malhar are different, and in Megh Malhar they would stop on ma, but in Megh they would not. But I sing Megh with the Malhar ang, but I do not stop on ma. Re pa re ma, I don't do this. Re pa re ma ni re sa, I come back to sa, I don't leave it at ma. So this is my approach to Megh. And now there's another raag which is very close to Megh, which is called Madhmad Sarang. So it's more chanchal. So I sang Vrindavani Sarang just now and then moved to Miyanka Sarang. Vrindavani Sarang is sa re ma pa ni sa ni pa re ni re. So it has both the knees. Ni pa ma re sa. But Madhmad Sarang has only komal. Ma pa ni sa ni pa re ni sa re sa re. There's a sea of difference between them. So there's a lot of mean. Andolan, oscillation. In Madhma Sarang, you don't have these. Ma pa ni sa re ma pa ma ni pa re ma pa ni pa re ma pa ni sa re sa ni pa ma pa ni pa ma re sa ma pa sa ni pa re ma ni pa re ni sa re sa. So now some people have started doing ni sa re pa ma re in Madhmad Sarang. But the old way of singing was re pa re re ma pa re. These are the old usages. But in Megh you won't do re pa re sa, not like this. Re pa re re ni re sa. Whereas in Madhmad Sarang, also in Madhmad Sarang you do ma ni pa re ma ni pa re. But in Megh you will do Nima Pare. Nima Pare Re Ni Sa Re Sa Re. Nima Pare Ni Re Sa. This is Megh. Ma Ni Pare Ni Sa Re Sa Re. Madhmad Sarang. So there's a big difference between these two. So I'll just sing a composition in jhaptaal in 10 beats. It's a dhrupad-ang composition, so I'll be using only tabla accompaniment here. Ah. Dhrupad in any raag, but Megh is especially suited to Dhrupad singing, which is why I'm not singing it in the khayal style here. So it's a traditional composition, Garaje Ghataa Ghan Kaare, in jhaptaal, 10 beats, 2, 3, 2, 3. So, Garaje Ghataa Ghan Kaare, Garaje Ghataa
Oh.
garaje ghata kaare 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 garaje garaje ghata kaare ghata kaare ghata kaare ghata kaare garaje garaje Okay, so now the floor is open to questions. Yes.
So the name that you sang right now was Surya Upadhyaya.
Huh.
So I was of the opinion that any, when you classify anything as Surya Upadhyaya, it becomes a sarang.
Oh, no. Sarang has a particular raganga, particular way of singing. So just because it's Surya Upadhyaya, it will not become sarang. This also has Surya Upadhyaya. It's a different thing. Surya Upadhyaya. So just making something sare ma pa ni will not make it sarang. Sarang has a particular gayaki. Ni sare sa de re straight way. Ni sare no. So megh, even though it is sare ma pa ni, it does not come in the sarang family. Because it has a different raganga. It has its own stuff and it has a lot of malhar stuff also. But it's ni sa ni. But this is megh's own thing. Yes? No, Megh has a bit of Malhar in it.
Only in some
place. Megh is a member of the Malhar family. At least that is how I see it. But
I mean, you don't need to listen to it, okay, to say it's a Megh or it's a Malhar like that.
Yeah, I mean, I explained that already.
Very Is it only in terms of the Megh and the Dhamaks?
Yes, those things and also which swara combinations come. So for example, I mean Megh versus Madhumad Sarang, if you say De ma pa ni pa de ni sa re sa de re. This is the uchcharan of Madhumad Sarang. But has more of this meaned based uchcharan, it's more vakra. Sa re ma pa will not come in meg. Sa re pa ni ma pa re pa ma pa ni sa ni pa ma re sa ni pa ma re So some people might sing Megh without the Malhar Ang also. But it still will be different from Sarang because Pasa Ni Re. Here you sing Pasa Ni Re. But in Madhma Sarang you would sing Pani Sare. In Megh you sing Mima Pare. In Madhma Sarang you sing Mani Pare. So the order of the swaras also matters. What? Sorry? Oh, so Shuddha Malhar and Megh.
Yeah.
Okay.
A clear Malhar and a clear
Megh. Re, 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 sa, sa, re, re, ma, pa, ni, ma, pa, re, re. So even if I don't, so ma, re, pa, even if I don't take this in Megh, I will still sing the re oscillating. Re, 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 ma, pa, ni, ma, pa, re, 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 sa, ma, pa, ni, pa, ni, sa, ni, sa, ni, pa, pa, re. But now Shuddha Malhar does not have ni, it has dha. And it is Uttarang Pradhan. And you stop on ma. Sa re ma pa dha sa. Sa re sa da pa ma pa ma. Re pa re ma sa re sa. But this phrase in Megh, it will become like re pa re ma. So some people say that Megh Malhar is different from Megh in the sense that if you just remove her from Shuddha Malhar and put Ni, then you get Megh Malhar. As in put Megh ka Nishan, then you get Megh Malhar. So some people will sing Megh Malhar like this, with more Shuddha Malhar influence. Ni sa re ma re pa re ma ma pa re. So in Shuddha Malhar, you get ma pa da sa da pa ma here ma pa ni sa ni pa ma re pa re ma ni re sa. So this is a distinct Megh Malhar that some people sing. Like for example, Pandit Ramashri Jha used to sing this Megh Malhar, and he sang it as distinct from Megh. But he still said that Megh itself has a Malhar Ang. It has the oscillated ray, but Megh Malhar has the additional Shuddha Malhar feature of stopping on the Madhyam. So I hope like that answered your question. Anything more? Yeah, definitely. If you change one little thing, the mood will change. Like for example, if you have Bhim Palasi. Gama pa ma pa, gama pa ni, da pa ma pa za ni, da pa pa da ma pa gama, gama ni pa gama, ma ga je sa. Now in Bhim Palasi, if I keep everything same and I just change the ni, sa ga ma pa. Gama pa ni re sa da pa, gama pa ni da ni sa ni da pa, da ma pa gama pa ni sa da pa ga ma ga re sa ga re sa. This is Patthi. I changed one swara. I changed ni from komal to tivra, and see what happened. It became something completely different. So yeah, even one tiny thing you change, the rag will change. That's how sensitive these rags are. They're like little children, you have to handle them with care, you know. And any more questions? Desh Malhar, I have not learned. So rag Desh, I will be singing on the third day. I mean, by that time, maybe I'll find out about Desh Malhar and get back to you. Anything more? That is a Mishra Swarup. It has many different raags combined. So, I mean, I haven't learned that, so I can't really tell you about that. But you can just listen to it on YouTube to get an idea of it. It's a mixture of many different raags. It has some Malhar, some Kanra, some this, some that. And different gharanas have different approaches to Meera Malhar. Even God Malhar, in fact, there are many different approaches. Like there's even a God Malhar with nut features in it. Like, aye, aye, re, jhumake. Hussein Khan in Agra Gharana. So this is nut anka God Malhar. It's a nut feature. So you have nut Malhar, you have God Malhar, and God Malhar also has many types. So this is a nut influenced variety of God Malhar. So again, it's not uniquely defined. Each person has a different God Malhar. So I cannot say only this is correct God Malhar and this is not. So like we still have 8 minutes, so if there are any more quick questions.
What is Sangeetan
Mishra? I have no idea. I mean, I certainly don't have any title before my name as of now. I don't know, at some point, you know, when you reach a certain age and you reach a certain level, people just start calling you Pandit or Ustad. Or, you know, Vidushi or something if you're a lady.
Is that common?
I don't think there's an actual thing which, you know, confers you that, you know, Pandit title or whatever. At some point, people just start calling you that. But personally, I wouldn't like any titles. Yeah. I mean, I have doctor from my PhD, that is enough for me.
Thank you everyone for coming. Thank you, Achindya.